Hey guys, today we are going to discuss about the Starling curve. Starling curve, it is a graphical representation relationship between the stroke volume and end diastolic volume. End diastolic volume, it is the volume which is present into the ventricle before the contraction, or it is the volume which is present into the ventricle before the opening of the semilunar valve. In the semilunar valve, there are two valves are present. In the left side, there is the aortic valve, and on the right side there is a pulmonary valve. And before the opening of the aortic or the pulmonary valve, the volume which is present into the ventricle, this volume is known as the end diastolic volume. This volume is also known as a preload. And what about the stroke volume? Stroke volume, it is a volume which is pushed out. It is a volume which is pushed out from the ventricle into vessel. This volume is known as a stroke volume. Stroke volume is also known as a cardiac output. When the ventricle systole, or the when the ventricle contract, and the volume which is pushed out from the ventricle to the vessel, this volume is known as a stroke volume or the cardiac output. This is a graphical representation. This one is a normal. This line in the graph is a normal. For example, in the ventricle, there is nearly about 30 milliliter of the blood is present into the ventricle. And normally, when the ventricle contract, nearly about 20 milliliter of the blood pushed out from the ventricle. 20 milliliter of the blood is pushed out from the ventricle. When the ventricle will pushed or contract, and 20 milliliter of the blood will pumped out from the ventricle, from the 30 milliliter, this is a normal. And there is a 20 milliliter of the blood, for example, this is a normal line. And when a person do exercise, then the demand of the oxygen and the blood increases in the tissue. So we need more oxygen and the more blood for the tissue nutrients. For this purpose, there is an active of the sympathetic nervous system. Sympathetic nervous system effect on the vessel and right atrium. There is present of the specific receptors on the heart, which is known as a beta 1 receptor. These are the beta 1 receptor. This sympathetic nervous system stimulate the beta 1 receptor. So through the beta 1 receptor, the contraction of the heart is increases. And also cardiac output is directly related to heart rate. It is directly proportional to heart rate, because cardiac output is equal to stroke volume and heart rate, and cardiac output is directly related to heart rate. So when we do exercise, during the exercise, the demand increases of the oxygen and the nutrients. So for this purpose, sympathetic nervous system is active. When the sympathetic nervous system will be active, it stimulates the beta 1 receptor, which is present on the heart. When the beta 1 receptor will be active, then it increases the contraction activity of the heart. When the contraction activity of the heart will be increases, then nearly about of the 20 to 25 milliliter of the blood will be pushed out from the ventricle. Nearly about the 25 milliliter. This one is giving just an example that from the 30 milliliter to 25 milliliter blood will be pumped out from the ventricle during the exercise. There will be 25 milliliter. Or when we use the drug which increases the contractility, for example, digoxin, dibutamide, the digoxin also increases the contractility. Digoxin also increases the contractility of the heart. When the contraction will be increased, then the volume which is present into the left ventricle, the right ventricle, this volume pushed out from the ventricle with a greater amount. And this, so that the curve is going to upward, going is rising here. And for example, when heart failure and angioxemia. When we are in, there is a heart failure, or when there is a mitral stenosis, preload decrease. Preload is decrease because this is difficult for the volume from the left atrium or the right atrium to pump into the ventricle. When the volume pushed down into the ventricle with a lesser amount, so the volume which is being pumped from the ventricle to the vessel is also decreasing. Yes. Also, when there is a heart failure, for example, there is a congestive heart failure disease, for example, when there is a cardiac tamponade, pericarditis, or there is a pancarditis, these diseases decrease the contractility and also the stroke volume. Even there is a nearly about 30 milliliter of the blood is present, but the volume which is pushed out from the ventricle decreases. So when we use the digoxin with this, digoxin increases the contractility of the heart. When it increases the contractility of the heart, then the muscles of the heart will move with the high contraction. And when the muscle of the heart will contract greater amount, then the vent from the ventricle move to the vessel in little bit lesser amount. So they are nearly about of the 15 milliliter, nearly about of the 15 milliliter of the blood will move out in the heart failure. And when the totally heart failure, we are not going to use of the digoxin or the digitalis group drugs, are the drugs which increase the heart rate. So in this way, the cardiac output is very low, because when the heart failure, then there is a problem also with the heart rate. Heart rate is low with the contraction problem. When the contraction will be lesser, then the volume pumped out from the ventricle into the vessel will be in the lesser amount. So here the graph is going downward. This is the showing the heart failure. And in this, nearly about of the 8 to 8 milliliter or the 10 milliliter of the blood will move out from the ventricle into the vessel. So this was the about Starling curve. Starling curve is the graphical representation between the stroke volume and the end diastolic volume.